Sometimes they think, what can I say? And other times, even in institutions of higher learning, such as this, these people think to themselves, where can I go?
Where can I go to palm a science major on the football field?
At Art and Dottie Todd's roast beef sandwich in the heart of
where can I go to get the ferry to take me into the Big Apple?
At the Roger Miller Inn, where you can go this Tuesday night.
Where can I go to learn how to play guitar like Alvin Lee?
At Earl Shive's paint job, where this week only
where
for $11
can I go
we'll do any
to
free
get my dingus mummified?
If I have any children, they'll go to jail too.
Where can I go to get the first part of that joke?
Questions, questions, questions flooding into the mind of the concerned young person today. Oh, but it's a swell time to be alive, even on Long Island. I'm sure that many of you have said to yourselves in the privacy of your own home, how glad you are that you don't live in Left Rack City. And then, of course, there are other people who really dig it, you know what I mean? Because the buildings are so attractive. There is nothing more modernistic than a square brick building with square, symmetrical windows. As any student of architecture will tell you, that is very advanced. That is art that has been carried past the point of creativity, past everything that the ancient architects have ever striven for, beyond the Parthenon, beyond the Eiffel Tower,
beyond
the Sabret hot dog stand,
beyond
the nearest Christie's market and the parking lot,
beyond the reef,
way, way on beyond that, down to sheer practicality. And I'm glad that somebody else designed those buildings. Because I would hate to feel responsible for it myself. What are you doing back here? Alright. Are you ready for the secret words?
Yeah.
Here they come. A moment of contemplation. Do this sensitively. Just like Donovan was performing his song. Get into it. Here they come. Muffin.
Los Angeles, I wouldn't kid you, I am your friend.
call this number in L.A. and I guarantee you a good time. Area code 213-469-2121. That's not a hard number to remember. That's area code 213-469-2121. You call it today because I'm telling you, you can call it correct. You can call it collect. You can call it direct. But guarantee you this, friends, and I wouldn't lie to you because you are my friends. You call this number today. Call it collect. Call it direct. But call it today!
Thank you. caught his daughter in the bus by the light, and he said to himself, she looks all right. He reached for a tit and grabbed it tight. So on across the lawn.
Because I want to say
yourself a Magdalena. I didn't mean to reach out and grab you the other night. I mean, I know your mother was away, and I looked at you in the hallway.
Your mama never.
And I said, my God, look at that child. Look at those tits. Look at that see-through blouse. And I reached out, Magdalena, and I grabbed your little titty. And your mama walked in and said, Harry, get your hands off your daughter. And I said, I can't help it, honey. She got me so hard. I know I gave my nerve to that child.
on my own.
Typical KACA.
you heard right, shove it right in.
You're so strong.
And pull it right out. And shove it in again. Rosamond and Gorman, and he's shaped like this. He goes up, rounded on the top, comes down, a little plateau, and growing off the plateau is a twisted tree. It looks like a wooden television antenna, and the tree's name is Ethel, and Ethel is married to the mountain, and the mountain's name is Billy. And then Billy comes down over here, and there's a foot. Billy has two big caves for eyes. He has a jaw, which is a cliff, and it sticks out like that. Hey, eat it. Eat it raw, buddy. Love is never having to say eat it.
All right.
Peace, love, Woodstock Nation, and eat it.
Fuck you.
Anyway, cliff sticks out. Whenever Billy the Mountain talks, it drops up and down about 30 feet. Dust and boulders puff out. And that's the way he works. All right? It's one of the things we like best about playing institutions of higher learning, especially in New York. Whatever happened to the Fillmore East audience?
Oh, and his eyeball caves! They-
jaw, well, it dropped 30 feet. A bunch of dust puffed out. Rocks and boulders were hacked up. Crushing the Lincoln. The big news to Ethel.
Ah!
And with dust and boulders hacked up everywhere, Billy choked with excitement, announced
Ethel, we're going on a vacation.
Ethel, like any little woman, she of course was very excited. She creaked a little bit, and some old birds flew off of her. Billy told Ethel they were going to...
Vegas. word just in to the WOR news service. Undeniably links this mountain and his wife to drug abuse and payoffs as part of a Manhattan Island smut ring. However, we can assure parents on Long Island that a recent narcotics crackdown in the Bronx, Queens, Boston, Cambridge, Seekonk, Saskatoon, and as near as Billy Mundy's house, will provide Governor Rockefeller the sneaky evidence he has needed to seek a criminal indictment and pave the way for stiffer legislation, increased federal aid, and avert a crippling strike of cafeteria workers and homosexual science majors throughout the entire campus. However, it is this reporter's opinion that Ethel is a former communist.
Hit the week, Jerry Lewis had hosted the telethon.
La, 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 nice lady.
To raise funds for the injured.
Right next to the Jack in the Box, right over the secret underground dumps where they keep the
pools of old poison gas and obsolete germ bombs.
Just as the freak tornado cruised through.
Ah, yes, it was about 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Little Howard Kaplan was sitting on the stoop squeezing his concertina. A mysterious wind blew up from the south.
Uncle Frank!
A mysterious wind blew down from the north.
Toto!
A mysterious wind blew across from the west.
Toto!
And another wind blew
down. Oh no! My God! Correctly, it was right outside of Detroit when Billy got his notice to report for his induction physical. Now let me tell you, brothers and sisters, can you dig a shaft right on?
Good God.
Solid. Ethel said she wasn't going to let him go.
I'm not going to let you go, Billy.
But George Pontoon, the right-wing radical, W-O-R, pinko, pricko, stick it up in the asshole, newscaster had this to say.
Take it away, George Pontoon, the right-wing fascist, pinko, pricko, stick it up your asshole, newscaster.
We now have confirmed reports from the informed Emperor Haile Selassie that Ethel is still an active communist. And it is this reporter's opinion that she also practices witchcraft.
Of course, it was about this time that the telephone rang inside of the secret briefcase belonging to the one mortal man who might be able to stop all of this senseless destruction and save America herself. And that man was, of course, Studebaker Hawk, low-budget hero of the current economic slump.
Now, some folks say he looked like Felix Pappalardi.
Felix Pappalardi.
Still others say, hey, bullshit, man. He was just another
guy was born next to the frozen meat pies down at the Safeway. And many more say named the Wayne Fiend because he was a crazy Italian who just happened to drive a red sports car. Nobody really knew for sure, you see, because he was so mysterious.
Never call me on the purple phone. They're listening all the time.
But Studebaker, it's me, Little Emil. I have the code.
Little Emil.
I have the code.
You got the code.
I got the code.
I got the pencil.
You got a pencil.
I got the pencil.
I got the code.
You got the code.
You got the code.
I don't got the code. You
got the code.
I got the pencil.
Here comes the code.
Okay, give me the code.
One hand.
One hand.
One hand, two ducks.
One hand, two
ducks. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese, four limerick oysters. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese, four limerick oysters, five corpulent porpoises. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese, four limerick oysters, five corpulent porpoises. Six pairs of Don Alberto's tweezers. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese, four limerick oysters, five corpulent porpoises. Six pairs of Don Alberto's tweezers. 7,000 Macedonians in full battle array. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese, four limerick oysters, five corpulent porpoises. Six pairs of Don Alberto's tweezers. 7,000 Macedonians in full battle array. Eight brass monkeys from the ancient sacred crypts of Egypt. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese, four limerick oysters, five corpulent porpoises, six pairs of Don Alberto's tweezers, 7,000 Macedonians in full battle array. Eight brass monkeys from the ancient sacred crypts of Egypt. Nine apathetic, sympathetic, diabetic, old men on roller skates with a marked propensity towards procrastination and sloth. One hand, two ducks, three squawking geese, four limerick oysters, five corpulent porpoises, six pairs of Don Alberto's tweezers, 7,000 Macedonians in full battle array. Eight brass monkeys from the ancient sacred crypts of Egypt. Nine apathetic, sympathetic, diabetic, old men on roller skates with a marked propensity towards procrastination and sloth. Ten lyrical, spherical, diabolical denizens of the deep. Walk way around the quail with the quibby of the quarry, all at the same time!
Oh my God! Oh no!
You got the cone?
I got the cone.
I got the pencil.
You got the pencil? A mountain?
Hadi-hadi-hada!
With a tree growing off of his shoulder? This is terrible. Causing untold destruction?
Suck, suck, suck.
Wanted for Draft evasion? Can I fly there immediately, say, and try to reason with him? Wow! An expense account? And per diem, too? Some men say he could dance.
And he could dance like a son of a bitch. And just to prove it, here it is, the Studebaker Talk Dancing Lesson and Cosmic Prayer for Guidance, featuring Aynsley Dunbar.
Hey!
Twirly, twirly.
Hey! Three from the east, three from the west, three from the north, three from the south.
Three from the right nostril.
Three from the tongue. Rangers, ho!
Twirly, 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 twirly.
Studebaker Hawk. Mysterious. Provocative. Homunculus. So many rumors have spread about Studebaker Hawk. Consider, if you will, this one, which was published recently in your very own campus newspaper, that he could write the Lord's Prayer on the head of a pizza.
Some men say he could write the Lord's Prayer on the head of a pizza. Head of a pizza.
Good, three dog night. Good. Say, all right. Three dog night.
Oh. Other still maintains a next to the frozen beef pie.
A frozen beef pie for David Crosby.
Find one in between a pair of
of customized trucks where nobody was looking. He cut out a pair of really, really, really nice wings, and he covered them thoroughly with foil.
Alright, Stony Brook University, that's why they never mind.
Hey!